Welcome to What's the Fluid? I'm your host, Tori, and today we're showing you how we like to install liquid cooling in the InWin 101. The 101 is part of InWin's aptly named Number Series, which has had broad appeal among mainstream gamers. As you can see in our review of the 101, though it's slightly smaller than the 305 we looked at a couple weeks ago, it still allows for a surprisingly large amount of cooling. We were very impressed with how almost all the space in the 101 is utilized to max out the cooling potential. Let's look at the radiators. At maximum capacity, the 101 can support 3 radiators total, but don't be overzealous. The 240mm mount on the side can support a maximum thickness of about 180mm, which is more than anyone would ever need, particularly if you aren't mounting your pump in this general vicinity. To give you some examples of what you can mount here, EK's thickest 240 radiator, the XE240, is 60mm thick. With standard 25mm thick fans in a push-pull config, you're looking at a total thickness of 110mm, leaving you 70 to spare. However, you're more than likely going to want to mount your pump and res in this area, so we went with an EK SE240, which is 30mm thick, and a set of 4 EK Varder fans in a push-pull config, coming in at 80mm in total thickness. Combined with the pump res combo mounted to the fans, this is the maximum thickness that fits. What is important to note is that due to the plastic pegs at the top of this removable 240mm mount, you're a little limited on what you can do. Since radiators are thicker at the end that has the tank and the G and a quarter ports, we ran into some issues when trying to mount the radiator with the ports at the top. We could have made it work with minimal modding to our SE240, but PE or XE radiators would have taken a little more work due to their extra length. It's a bummer because just a few millimeters would make all the difference in this situation. The bottom of the case, similar to the 305, supports a full 360mm radiator. But if you're using a 240mm radiator in the side mount, you'll not be able to fit a 360 radiator in the bottom. If InWin had not included the fan ducts on the removable 240mm mount and allowed us to put fans on the other side of the radiator, you would have been able to fit both. In fact, if you took a Dremel to the ducts, you could definitely make this work as the ducts are the perfect thickness, but the goal of these videos is to show what can be done in a case without having to mod. It looks like InWin did move the mounting ports slightly forward as the front panel cables felt slightly less cramped with our PE240 radiator in there. On the back, you can fit a 120mm radiator if you wish, but it's a pretty tight fit, so only an SE120 will make it. We would much rather have a fan here to exhaust the hot air from the other radiators than to try and fit another radiator in just because we can. So that in mind, you have two options. You can either fit a pair of 240 radiators on the bottom and side, or you can fit a 360 on the bottom and a 120 on the side. Due to the only fan filter in the case being at the bottom, we've decided to set up both radiators to pull in fresh air from the outside of the case and have the back 120mm fan pushing as much of that hot air out as possible. In order to optimize temps, we would recommend having the fans on both of your radiators facing in the same direction, either pulling in air from the outside or exhausting air from the inside of the case. If you have one pulling air in and one exhausting, the one exhausting the air is going to be using partially recycled air from the first radiator, and it won't be as effective as it could be otherwise. There aren't a lot of places for mounting a separate reservoir, so we would highly recommend using a pump res combo. You can't mount anything to the front panel because any holes you poke through will be visible from the outside. You could mount a reservoir to the top fan of the 240mm radiator and the pump to the bottom of the case or the bottom fan, but that just overly complicates the situation when a pump res combo would be much cleaner and cheaper. If you really insist on using a separate pump and reservoir, you could mount the res to the top of the case and attach the pump to one of the 120mm fans using EK's fan adapter. This could add a cool effect that would be very plainly visible when the glass panels on, but it's kind of in the way of everything and would make future maintenance a bit difficult. Do yourself a favor, keep it simple, and go with a pump res combo and mount it to one of the fans, either the far right fan if you decided to put a 360 radiator at the bottom of the case, or the bottom fan of the side 240 if you went that route. If you wanted to go with a slightly thicker radiator and still maintain having a push-pull config with your fans, you could use the slightly smaller DDC pump, but our preferred pump has always been the D5, and that's what we'll be using for the remainder of this build. Plus, we're a sucker for this beautiful full plexi combo unit. For reference, our CPU block in this build is the new Supremacy Evo RGB from EK and matching RGB 1080 Ti Founders Edition GPU block. To start assembly, we'll remove the 240mm radiator mount from the chassis. It is plastic, so be gentle when unscrewing the three screws in the back of the case. Once the screws are removed, you simply lift up and out. First, we'll lay the radiator down with the G and a quarter ports facing the table. Next, we'll place the fans on top of the radiator so the holes line up with each of the mounting points on the radiator. The sticker side of the fan should be facing down as we want our air to come from the outside of the case. Finally, we'll place the whole mount on top of the fans and screw in our first screw in one of the corners. Tighten the screw diagonal from the first one, followed by the other two corners, and finally the four in the middle. Now we'll flip the whole unit over and mount our pump res and additional fans. The easiest mounting solution is to use the 120mm adapter mount that EK provides for mounting their pumps and combo units. We just attach the pump res combo by screwing in the four provided screws and route the cables through the back of the bracket to keep them out of the way and hidden from view. Once done, we'll line it up with the bottom fan and tighten the four screws in a diagonal pattern to secure the adapter plate and fan to the radiator. Next, we'll attach the top fan by repeating the process. The stickers on these fans will face up to match the direction of the first two fans. Before we put the whole unit back into the case, we're going to route the fan power cables through the cable management holes that InWin has included. If you feel comfortable, we would also recommend threading these pump cables through the holes, but if you're using a D5 like we are, you need to depin the Molex terminals from the connector first. It's a very easy process, but it does require a special tool. We'll include a link in the description if you would like to order one. Once all the cables have been threaded through, you simply replace the entire unit in the case the same way you removed it. When tightening the screws to secure the mount to the case, be gentle as the plastic is soft and can strip relatively easily. Next, we'll mount the other two fans to our second 240mm radiator using the same process as the first. For this one, the fan stickers will be facing up and be on the same side as the G and a quarter ports. We also want to make sure that the cables are on the side that's going to face the motherboard, so our cables aren't in the front of our case. Similar to the 305, we need to make sure our front panel cables are already connected before installing the radiator. We also want to plug in our fans for this radiator before installing it, as it'll be tricky once the radiator has been secured to the case. Once the cables have been taken care of, we need to flip the case on its back, remove the back foot, and then secure the radiator to the case using the short screws that EK provides with each radiator. Our first tube run goes directly from the pump res to the bottom 240 radiator. The second run goes from the bottom 240 to the far left inlet on the GPU. For our build, we've decided to have our CPU and GPU blocks in parallel. What that means is water flows both into and out of the CPU and GPU blocks simultaneously, compared to serial that pushes water through one at a time. Parallel loops work best when each block in the setup is exactly the same, such as a multi-GPU setup or multiple RAM blocks like we did in our steampunk build. Parallel setups like this one, where it's two different blocks with two different flow restriction rates, require more flow and can be trickier to bleed, but we're doing it for the aesthetics. If you don't care as much about the aesthetics, feel free to arrange your blocks in serial. We'll just be extra careful when it comes to bleeding our loop so we get out all of the air bubbles. As you can see, parallel setups also take two additional fittings. Now that we've set up our parallel tubes, our next run utilizes a 90 degree angle fitting off of the right G and a quarter port on the GPU to the other 240 radiator. Then our final run goes from the 240 radiator back into the pump res, utilizing a second 90 degree fitting. In this build, we use Charmander saliva for the fluid. Be careful milking your Charmanders, they bite. And that's it. Here's some beauty shots for you. We have to admit, after building in the 101, we're big fans. The 101 is an amazing case for the price at $70, though sometimes you can find it on sale for about 50 bucks. You get all the same features as the 303 and the 305. The only compromise you're making is some external aesthetics and 120mm of radiator surface area, but you're probably not putting two GPUs in a $70 case, so two by 240 radiators will be more than plenty. Overall, water cooling in this case is a breeze and would be a great start for any novice or pro looking to do an easily maintainable loop. Let us know in the comments which EK product you think would make the best starter Pokemon. Vardar, I choose you!